Hello everyone, this is Dr. Shweta Shah from Mumbai. In the previous video, we had seen the factors affecting the male and female infertility and the importance of timely evaluation of an infertile couple. Today in this video, I am going to discuss regarding the basic tests which are required for evaluation of an infertile couple. Now, in the male partner, the basic test which is required, that is known as the semen analysis. Now, this test gives us an idea regarding the count of the sperms, the motility of the sperms, and the normal sperms. Depending upon the result of this test, whether it is normal or abnormal, further hormonal testing and further imaging of the male reproductive system is ordered. When we come to the female part, there are three tests which are absolutely necessary, divided under the three headings. Now, the first few tests will give us an idea whether the ovulatory function is normal or abnormal. These are basically hormones like serum TSH, serum prolactin, and a very important test which is known as the serum AMH. Now, serum TSH is ideally done in the fasting state and it has to be done on the day 2 of the periods. Then there is another hormone which is known as serum prolactin. Now, this hormone goes a lot of variation in the entire 24 hours, and therefore this hormone is best tested in the morning hours between 10 to 11 a.m. and there is no need of fasting for this hormone to be tested. Then we have an important test which is known as the serum AMH, which is the anti-Müllerian hormone. Now, every woman is born with an egg bank within herself. As the age advances, there is a natural process by which the eggs are getting destroyed in her body. Now, AMH gives us an idea regarding how much time the woman has on her biological clock to conceive either naturally or with doctor's assistance, which may be in the form of simple follicular monitoring or intrauterine insemination or IVF. Now, the absolute value of AMH is also correlated with the women's age and something known as the antral follicle count, which is seen on the ultrasonography of the pelvis. Then there is one more test that we do for ruling out the uterine causes of infertility, and that is known as the transvaginal sonography or USG pelvis. Now, in this sonography, we evaluate the uterine factors, especially the uterine cavity and the lining of the uterus, which is known as the endometrium. We look for any fibroids, any polyps, any septum, any abnormally shaped uterus while doing the sonography. Then I also spoke about something known as the AFC, which is the antral follicle count. This gives us an idea about the basic eggs the woman has during that cycle in each of the ovaries. Then we do tests to evaluate the tubal factors or the fallopian tubes. There are two tests available for evaluation of the fallopian tube. One is known as the HSG, that is the hysterosalpingography, and the other is known as diagnostic laparoscopy with chromoperturbation. Now, HSG is a X-ray of the fallopian tube taken while the woman is conscious, and it is a very painful procedure. A dye is injected through her vagina, and that dye is seen coming out through her tubes if the tubes are open. Whereas a diagnostic laparoscopy with chromoperturbation is a procedure in which a short anesthesia is given to the woman, and the dye is injected through her vagina, and this dye is seen through a telescope or a camera which is inserted into the woman's belly, and the pictures are taken and they are transferred on the monitor. Now, in a simple language, if I want to compare the test results of an HSG and a diagnostic laparoscopy with chromoperturbation, I give an example of a scenario where before marriage, when the girl and boy are meeting, they first see the photographs, and when they meet in reality, how much difference is noticed, that much difference is noticed when we see the tubes through an HSG and when we see the tubes through a diagnostic laparoscope. Thank you.